Hey YouTube, iPodX142 here, and in this video, as you can see, we're in a little bit of a different set here. We're in my car, and we're going to be taking a look at Apple CarPlay, specifically how you can get any application to work with it. So if you don't know, there's actually a jailbreak tweak that you can get called CarBridge, which allows you to run any application on your iPhone through CarPlay in your CarPlay compatible device. So obviously this does require you to have a jailbroken device, and if you don't have one, then you can check out my jailbreak guides that will be linked in the video description. Unfortunately, it's not available for every single version of iOS yet, but obviously, as long as you can jailbreak, you can do this. So it's pretty cool. And if you have a jailbreak, it's a very nice little feature for you to use with CarPlay. So normally Apple's pretty restricted in which apps that you can have with CarPlay. There's a few on the App Store, mostly navigation or music related ones that are actually compatible with CarPlay out of the box. But for the most part, most apps just aren't, either because the developers aren't allowed to put it on there, or it's not deemed safe to have it on in a car environment, basically. But this just allows you to use it. Obviously, I do recommend you know, use this with caution. Don't be watching videos while you're driving or anything, but this is something that you can do nonetheless. So all you need to do is go over to Cydia or Cilio on your device, and you just need to download this tweak called CarBridge. Now, it's not free, unfortunately. It is $4.99, but that is basically nothing if you want to have these kind of features in your car. It's very, very easy to use, and it works very well, actually. It's not 100%, you know, it doesn't work perfectly, but it is pretty good, and we'll have a look at that now. So once you've got the tweak installed, just head over to the settings application, and if you scroll down to, you see CarBridge. As you can see, we've got a few different options in here. We can first of all choose which applications we want to bridge over to CarPlay. As you can see, I've got these ones on there at the moment. So we've got Google Maps, which is already on there, but if you have an application that already has a CarPlay version and you bridge it through this, it will push the full version of the application through, which is especially useful for Spotify, which we'll have a look at. But yeah, these are the applications we've got enabled. As you can see, you just sort of go into it and then just enable the toggle, tap on which preferred orientation you prefer, play around with this for different applications to see which one suits you better. Like for example, a videos application will work better in landscape. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is to this. And as soon as you do that, they'll actually show up on your CarPlay head unit here. So as you can see, we've got all the default apps on our first page here. Now if we scroll over, we've got all of those applications that we saw that are enabled. Now obviously, like I said, most apps will work perfectly fine. So if we go into Facebook, for example, just open this up. As you can see, we're going to go to search. I'm just going to take a look at my Facebook page, which if you want to follow is linked in the video description. But as you can see, you can scroll through, you can go ahead and you could post something if you wanted to. It brings up a keyboard and everything. Camera works through here if you wanted to do that for some reason. And yeah, it's a pretty cool little application there that works fine. If we also go back out, we can see we've got Messenger for Spotify. As you can see, if we open this up, we'll actually get the full version of Spotify rather than the CarPlay version. So if we went into, like, I don't know, any playlist here really, it's just going to like songs. As you can see, you can start queuing stuff up if you want to. Let's just get into that. You can start queuing stuff up, which isn't something you could do in the CarPlay version of the Spotify application, which is pretty cool. All the sound still works and everything, which is pretty nice. YouTube is a pretty cool one, so you can watch videos while you're parked up or something on this head unit, which is obviously a little bit bigger than your phone display. So we can go ahead and just search for anything we want. As you can see, keyboard's all good. Just search for one of my videos, just open it up, and as you can see, it starts playing perfectly fine. Frame rate's all good, and as you can see, you can make it full screen and it works perfectly fine. So we just skip the ad there. And as you can see, the video works. It does have sound and everything as well, as you can see. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is to this. There is another couple of extra features that you can do with this as well. So if we go back out of the YouTube application here, and then we take another look at our phone, if we go back into the CarPlay or CarBridge settings, as you can see, there's an option here called Show Portal App. If we turn that on, as you can see, we get this portal app, which will appear here, which I'll show you in a second. And there's also an option to change the amount of icon columns there are. So if you want more icons on one page, you could do that as well. If we have a look at this portal application here, basically what that does is just allows you to mirror your iPhone screen to the head unit. So if there's any apps that don't really function properly, you could just open it up on your device and mirror this. For example, Netflix doesn't work properly through this, but you could just view Netflix on your phone and then mirror it to the screen here. And as you can see, it works perfectly fine. Unfortunately, you can't control the phone through this, but it's a pretty cool feature nonetheless. And so yeah, that's pretty much all there is to CarBridge. Like I said, it's a really, really cool tweak that's available on the Cilio or Cydia, and it's pretty cheap if you want to download it. So I really recommend giving it a try. It's really worth the money if you use CarPlay a lot. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if this is the kind of videos you're interested in, doing a lot of stuff like this. So make sure to get subscribed if you're interested in this kind of thing. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Like the video if you liked it. Leave a comment if you have any questions. And as always, don't forget to subscribe.